to be alive, be counted among the living, and not among the dead. What a mighty God we serve. We're grateful to God for this privilege to come and to share again in the house of the Lord. We thank Him for another privilege to be able to look into His Word. We're grateful to see each of you that are here this morning in the land of the living. God is a good God. Oh, thank you, Lord. Every time I look around, He keeps on blessing me. Call your attention this morning to Psalms 121. Psalms 121. Feel like I've been preaching a revival this week, so I'm a little sluggish, but I'll be all right.
That's right.
Amen. A little tired.
That's right.
But it's a blessing to be alive.
Yes, it is.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Yes. Psalms 21, verses 5, 6, and 7. Psalms 121, verses 5, 6, and 7. And he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper.
Yes, he is.
The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand.
That's right.
The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thy soul. Let me read this again, because this is such a beautiful passage. He that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. And the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thy soul.
That's right.
I want to talk this morning from this thought. He protects your blind side.
Oh, yeah.
Huh? Oh, somebody get that after a while. He protects your blind side. Huh? Amen. Maybe somebody want to change that and say, He protects my blind side. Huh? Look at somebody and say, neighbor, He protects your blind side. And all of us got a blind side. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, most of us are used to football.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
And most of us that watch football,
yes, sir,
most time focus all our attention on one or two players.
Y'all do.
Huh?
Y'all do.
You know, because all of us either have a favorite player or favorite position.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Amen,
amen, amen, amen. And many will focus on the receiver because he catches passes.
Yes, he do.
Huh?
Yes, he do.
Huh? And often run touchdowns.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes.
Others focus on the strength and the power of the running back. Because he's the one that breaks through those virtual steel walls.
That's right. That's
huh? Amen. And many eyes are on the quarterback.
There you go.
Huh?
There you go.
Because really the quarterback is kind of like the on-field general,
yes,
of the team.
Yes, sir.
Isn't that right?
That's right.
Yeah, yeah, great quarterbacks. What I want to say to us today is the fact that no matter how great the quarterback.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
When he tries to throw with his right arm, he turns away from his left for a moment.
That's right.
Or somebody, I'll get that after a while. And during that moment when he's unaware of approaching tackler, he could be injured, or at the most sacked, the left side, that side that he can't see, is referred to as the blind side. An offensive tackler is a player whose job it is to protect the quarterback from danger seen and unseen. On his blind side. Man, we may not play professional football, but each of us have a blind side. Or somebody, I know I'll get back to you at the minute. Isn't that right?
That's right.
In other words, we all have points of weaknesses. Huh? Can I say that again? I said we all have points of weaknesses. Huh? That dark area that when left unprotected, can bring each of us down. It's good to know, and I need to say to you today that it's good to know that our God will not suffer the sun to smite us by day or the moon by night. Can I tell somebody this morning that God got your blind side? God got your blind side. I wish y'all could feel that. I said, God got your blind side. As Christians, we praise God for protecting us. Not only does God protect us, but God also preserves us. Both night and day. I mean, you know there are dangers every day. We really don't know how many dangers the Lord have brought us through. Just getting up out of your chair could be dangerous. Isn't that right? Sitting down in the chair that you're in now, amen, could have been dangerous. Isn't that right? Walking in this building could have been dangerous, but God takes care of us. Through danger seen and unseen. And I tell you that it gives me joy. It gives me joy to know that he protects my blind side. Things that I didn't see coming. God already know about. Isn't that right? Things I didn't know anything about. God already know about. Looked at this text and listened to David as David, he relates his confidence. David said that God will protect his people. Listen what he did. David was always confident that God would protect him. David said, I will lift up my eyes to the hills. In other words, God would not allow them to suffer utter defeat. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. Verse 6 and 7 use the word preserve three times. Huh? In other words, what he's saying is that God will build a thorny hedge.
That's right.
Around us. Huh? This is the truth that David wanted believers to know, that God will build a thorny hedge around his people to preserve them. Huh? Somebody might say, why a thorny hedge? A thorny hedge will keep the evil influences out. Huh? But at the same time, the thorny hedge will protect us from ourselves. It'll keep us on the inside. God protects our going out and our coming in. God protects us day and night. Isn't that right? First thing I want to talk to us about today is that he protects us. Huh? He protects. Huh? In many ways. Huh? In many ways. I need you to get this. In many ways, we are the quarterbacks of our daily life. Huh? In many ways, we are the quarterbacks of our daily life. What are you saying, preacher? I'm saying that every day we execute plays given to us by the Lord. Who is our coach?
That's right.
Huh? Well, you'll get it after a while. Huh? As we try, listen. Every day is a contest, and you have to try to win every day.
That's right.
Isn't that right?
That's right.
Why you say that, preacher? Because the devil is trying his best to get you.
Yes, he is.
Huh?
Yes,
well, every day the devil is trying his best to get you, but thanks be to God. He's looking out for my blind side. Huh? Isn't that right? What he does is he uses the shade on my right hand. Huh? He uses the shade on my right hand. David says, God is a shade upon thy right hand. The right hand. The right hand for a right-handed person. The right hand is the working hand.
Yes, it is.
Huh?
Yes, it is.
You're right-handed. The right hand is a working hand.
Yes.
Huh?
That's right.
Provide a shade for the right hand. God would be close enough to provide a shade. Huh?
Yes,
sir. In our everyday work, God is close to us.
Yes, he is.
Huh?
Yes, he is.
Isn't that right?
That's right.
He's always close by watching.
That's right.
God is close by protecting us.
That's right.
Huh?
Yes, he is.
As we're trying to carry out our duties, God is right there.
Yes, he is.
Moses found him to be a protection in the wilderness.
That's right.
Huh? The disciple found him to be protective shield in the storm.
Yeah.
Israel found him to be protection during the Egyptian bondage.
That's right.
And during the Egyptian slavery. But I tell you, God is really not like an offensive tackle in football.
Yeah.
Because nothing gets back up. Can I say that again? I said nothing gets by God. Huh? Amen. Huh? Huh? Yeah. Nothing gets by him that he don't want to get by. See, sometimes God lets some things by, but they come by because he want them to get by. And anything get by him, they get by him for his reason and for his purpose.
Isn't
that right?
That's right.
Yeah. It's a consolation for us to know Huh? Can I say that?
Oh, yeah.
I said God gives us hope.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
When the quarterback of a team knows that he has his blind side protected.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
His confidence is strength.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
He knows that he will be saved from attack.
Yeah, that's right.
With a strong offensive lineman protecting him.
That's
right. Somebody may say, preacher, how does that apply to the believer? I want you to look at Psalm 130 and verse number 7. It said, let Israel hope in the Lord. Huh?
Amen.
It means that you place the focus of your belief and faith in the hands of God.
That's right.
Huh?
That's right.
It doesn't mean that you never look, amen, to your left.
That's right.
But it does mean that you focus on the right.
That's right.
Isn't that right?
That's right.
Amen. Without an overriding fear of the left being unprotected, because you know blind side. Isn't that right? Those who hope in the Lord focus on the fact that God is the deliverer.
Yes, he is.
Huh? We can know that God is not only a deliverer, but he's also a provider.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Focus on God doesn't make you naive.
That's right.
Huh?
Amen.
Huh? Not, doesn't make you irrational.
That's right.
Huh?
Amen.
Trusting God simply means that there is power.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
God has power beyond anything in this world.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, amen.
Oh, so rather than fear what you'll do, amen, we learn how to put our trust
in him,
in the Lord.
Yes,
yeah, my mother used to say, the Lord will make a way.
Yes, he will. Oh, yes.
Huh?
Yes, he will.
Not only will he make a way, he made a way.
Already.
Huh?
Already.
And let me tell you this, he's still making a way right now.
Already.
Because if it wasn't for the Lord, I wouldn't be able to stand here today.
Right.
But because he's on my side.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
God is able.
Yes.
Anybody here know he's able?
Yes.
You don't have to fear what may happen.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
And be afraid to move or to throw a pass. You ought to be able to just find your receiver.
That's right.
Focus on what must be done and know. Every situation, no matter how bad it is, God keeps saying, I got you blind side.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
I'm the shade on your right hand. Go forth.
That's right.
Huh?
Amen.
That's why David declared that I will lift up my eyes unto the hill, from which cometh my help.
Yes.
I want you to know my help. Could anybody say my help?
My
help come from the Lord, who made both heaven and the earth. Huh? Not only does he shade my right hand, not only does he protect us from unseen, amen, not only does he give us hope, but he protects us.
That's right.
From unseen danger.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Could you tell somebody he protects us?
He protects us.
He protects us.
He protects
from unseen danger.
Yes,
huh?
Yes, sir.
See, I found out that most of us can prepare for dangers we can see coming our way.
Right.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
But what troubles us are the dangers that we don't see. Huh?
That's
huh?
Yes,
the hit we take in life nature of the journey.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Amen.
Most of us that know all that God has done for us. Isn't that right?
Right.
Yeah. Psalms 121:3-4 reminds us that God will not allow our feet to slip.
Right.
He will not sleep on the job. Because he that keepeth Israel neither slumbers nor sleep. It's the prayer that we need answered, a help in times of trouble. We have the assurance that our God always have our blind side. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, lastly, that God is working the blind side. Oh, somebody ought to tell him, thank you. God is working the blind side. I want you to know that the devil never stopped trying. But God, the God of Jesus, always protects our blind side. Heard David said, why? The Lord will preserve thy soul. And that he will preserve thy going out and thy coming in forevermore. I don't know about you, but that's good to know. Because the word tells us that the devil is always trying to sack the quarterback. Isn't that right? Especially when he tries to take advantage of the blind side. Most believers here have a good side.
That's right.
And then they have a bad side.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Yeah. I know some of us think we only have a good side.
That's right.
But all of us have a bad side.
That's right.
A bad side oftentimes show up when you least expect it.
Yes, sir.
Confidence.
Yeah.
thank him for protecting my blind side. And in my confusion, God give me direction. I want to thank him for protecting my blind side. In God, all right, in my despair, he bring me hope. Thank God for protecting my blind side. Yeah, brother and sister, yeah, if you're going to play in the game, this game called life, we got to suit up for the game. And don't worry about your blind side. In God, all right, I read the Lord saying, if you're going to play in the game, first of all, you're going to need a good helmet. Helmets protect the head from collisions. That is sure to come when you put heads. In God, all right, I heard Paul say, put on the helmet of salvation. In God, all right, every helmet come with special equipment. A shin guard. Ain't God all right? The Holy Spirit is built, amen, to protect our shin. Ain't God all right? Every now and then, when things are down in your life, amen, it reminds us to keep our shin up, because everything is going to be all right. Ain't God all right? I'm glad. Suit up. Don't worry about your blind side. Ain't God all right? But I'm glad you need a mouthpiece. Ain't God all right? Mouthpiece is essential in the contest. Keep his mouthpiece, keep it in place. Ain't God all right? The mouthpiece keep you from saying the wrong thing or talking at the wrong time. Ain't he all right? I heard David in Psalm 39 when he said, I'll take heed to my ways. And I sin not with my tongue. I'll keep my mouth with a bridle while the wicked is before me. I stop to tell somebody, don't go to battle without your mouthpiece. Ain't God all right? Stretch somebody and say, neighbor, suit up. Put on your shoulder pad. Ain't God all right? Cause every now and then, you're gonna have to take a hit from the devil. Ain't he all right? You shoot up, touch somebody, and say, neighbor, shoot up, put on your cleats. In a Super Bowl, ain't he all right? However, you can say with assurance, our team will win. We know our team will win because of our lineup. Ain't God all right? Genesis at the right end. There is revelation. what you need to lift you up when you're down. Oh my God. There's a man here that I love very dearly. He's very dear to my heart. Amen. And I tell you, it does my heart good to see him today. Amen. 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 Oh. I look at this because I know what we're talking about. I look at this to get it real, man. You come in because you want to become a part of this church. Amen. God bless your heart. Because y'all know this story far. Amen. Amen. Also, the children you saw last week. Amen. Grandchildren. Amen. Amen. I know this was tough for him. Around St. Paul so many years. I think he's crying now for St. Paul. Amen. Amen. From 1942 to now. Amen. 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 He been wanting to do this, but he been had so many mixed emotions about where he were and where he wanted to be. Thing. You just trust
in the Lord
and give God time. Amen. And this is part of my family through marriage. Now, I've been giving him the oldest spot, but last time we were together, I don't know if it's him or Della May, but they right there close together. Amen. I know he the oldest in 4 miles. Amen. Of his family. He's the oldest one in the family. Amen. Amen. And so we are just so grateful to have you come and to be part of this church. And it's my prayer this church will be everything you'd hoped it to be, and then even more. We're going to accept you on your Christian experience, and we are just so grateful for you. But with it, we're going to stay close. Love you, man. God bless your heart. Amen. Let me give him an amen. Thank you.